Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, yesterday we solved Shawn's problem, and I was looking at a data set, and I mentioned that big, huge formula that was in the Excel Gurus Gone Wild book, and I want to set that up. I'm going to talk about that formula tomorrow, but let's talk about when we need to figure out the number of days elapsed between two dates. So let's say that we have to bill for both the start date and the end date. If we're just trying to figure out the number of days, it's pretty simple. The later date minus the earlier date is going to say that there's one day that's elapsed, and so we want to add one to that. And double click to send that formula down, and we can figure out the number of days. But what if you only work Monday through Friday, and you only want to bill for the Monday through Friday dates? There's a great function that was in the analysis tool pack called equal NETWORKDAYS. NETWORKDAYS. Start from the start date, go to the later date, and it's going to only count Monday through Friday dates. So right here in the first one, the number of days and the number of work days is exactly the same. But let me extend that through to Saturday, 7/5/2008, which was a Saturday. You said there's 3 days elapsed, but only 2 work days. Isn't that cool? Now, NETWORKDAYS is always available in Excel 2007. In Excel 2003, you had to make sure that the analysis tool pack was turned on. Go to Tools, Add-ins, and check the box for analysis tool pack. NETWORKDAYS is really cool in that you can also give it a third argument that says, hey, I want to ignore certain company holidays. So out here we'll enter a formula, and optional third argument will come out and point to this range that has holidays. I'll press F4, and let's see, get rid of that extra equal sign. And you see that because July 4th in the United States is a holiday, it now excludes that. So, very cool, cool way to go. All right, now I'm going to throw a curveball at you. We want to count the number of Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays in there. Maybe someone's part-time, they only work those 3 days. So, take out the Monday, Wednesday, Friday dates. All right, well, first of all, I have to wrap my head around the weekday function. I can never remember how this works. So, we'll put in today's date. I'll format that to show what day of the week it is. And grab the fill handle down, so that way I have a nice range of every Monday through Friday date. Equal weekday says check this date. I'll press F4 three times using this return type. Press F4 twice. All right, so the return types are 1, 2, and 3. We'll copy that down and copy it over. All right, so you see that the weekday function has different return types. One of them says that Sunday is a 1 going through Saturday being 7. Another one says that Monday is a 1 going through Sunday being 7. And then yet another one has Monday at 0 going through Sunday as 6. You know, if you don't want to memorize these, here's just a cool way to go. Let's use the mod function. Take the date, divide by 7, and get the remainder. Now we'll have to format that as a number. Copy that down, and we can just look. If we want Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, that's where the result of this function is either a 2, a 4, or a 6. 2, 4, or 6. All right, so here's what we're going to do. I'm going to switch over to VBA. I'm going to create a new custom function. So instead of starting with the word sub, I start off with the word function, the name of my function, and the arguments. I want a start date and an end date. Very important, that name of the function has to be a variable that you're going to set a value to within the function. And I'm going to create a little loop here for I equals start date to end date, select case. I want to do the mod function. So start, or actually I mod 7. That's going to return a number from 0 to 7. The only times that I care about are where the result is 2, 4, or 6. So case 2, 4, 6. In those cases, Monday, Wednesday, Friday is equal to Monday, Wednesday, Friday plus 1. End select. And next I. All right, so now we have a nice little function here, the Monday, Wednesday, Friday function. Let's just give that a try back here in our original data set. Equal Monday, Wednesday, Friday of the start date, comma, the end date. And copy that down, and now that custom function is figuring out the number of just Monday, Wednesday, Friday dates. You can very easily customize this for any days of the week. Just put the result of the mod function that you want. So, for example, if we wanted to add in Thursday, we would add 5, comma, and now we're getting Thursdays as well, and so on. So, just a quick little bit of VBA code there. Again, as I mentioned on Tuesday, the Live Lessons Power Excel Macro is a product from Q. We'll teach you how to write code. Now, tomorrow, we're going to look at an insane formula that's going to solve this problem without using any VBA whatsoever. Actually, it's a very clever formula. So, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another NETcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another NETcast from Mr.